The third idea is this: it also teaches something that modern society needs very, very badly. It gives us a prescription of what happens when different civilizations meet up. When people from different cultures, different races, different religions are somehow forced to live with each other or live in the same society, there is always friction. And there will be a tendency for one to overwhelm the other and demolish it. Now, again, I make critical comment, but I'd like to make critical comment about Hindus as well as non-Hindus. If you look at the European civilization, wherever they went, say North America, South America, Australia, they would demolish the local civilization. They demolished it. They overwhelmed it. Now, this is almost brutal. It's almost like survival of the fittest, animal kingdom entering the human level, and the human beings behaving like animals. You see, with this ancient one, we had a different idea. You see, the idea of the Northern Indian Empire coming into conflict or getting into touch with the Southern Indian Empire, and there was friction in the guise of Sita being abducted. This is the deeper story of Ramayana. Two civilizations were meeting up, and there was friction, and there was war, there was fighting. This is the deeper idea. And Ram's side won. So did he say, okay, now you are my colony, I'll send you a governor to rule you, and I'll rule you from Ayodhya? Did he say that? He said, nah, you are the best of friend. We will work together. Assimilation and integration, not death and destruction. So with the fact that I won doesn't matter. The younger brother, you take over. You run the kingdom. I go back to my kingdom. Now, you see, the first time the northern and southern empires were united, became unified because of this attitude, not overwhelming, not trying to control others, learning to be friends with others. Now you say, Dilip uncle, what's the point of this today in London today? We are not going to have a fight of Ram and Ravan. So what are you on about? Don't you see the same issue arising again? People of different religions and cultures having to live with each other and friction. That's what's happening. Pick up the newspaper every day. Fireworks. Not the one outside. This one. Fireworks all the time. Where is the resolution? How can you really allow different cultures to coexist? Resolution from this ancient hero. Learn to assimilate and integrate. Take the best of the others, adopt it and make it your. And let them borrow the best of yours, adopt it and integrate it within their system. This is how you produce, this is how evolution takes place. This is how you produce a more evolved society. You take the best from both and produce a more solid, much more integrated, much more advanced civilization. This is what it's supposed to do. Again, see the story of Ram, and the story of Ram incorporates this idea of different cultures coming together and becoming integrated. Now you see, I've said lots of some rough things about the European culture, especially about North and South America, and it's historic fact. I'm not making anything up. But I must also pass some critical comments about the Hindus too. You say, Dilip uncle, Diwali, come on, don't be critical on us. We are such lovely people here. Look. We Indians or Hindus have the same opportunity to take the best from the West, combine it with the best of ours, and produce a very integrated, very highly advanced civilization. We have that opportunity.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.